What is a cap rate? A capitalization rate, or cap rate for short, is an answer to a fundamental question that should be on the mind of every real estate investor. For every dollar this property costs me to acquire, how much can I expect to receive back each year in net rental income? In short, a property's cap rate is simply a ratio of its income divided by its cost or value. It's a number that helps investors convert a property's income into value. It's one way, but not the only way, of measuring a rate of return for an income-producing property. The math behind cap rates is pretty simple. It's net operating income divided by market value or cost. Likewise, when you know what the cap rate is in any given market, you can also use this number to calculate the value of a property by dividing the correct cap rate by your net operating income. Net operating income divided by the cap rate gives you your market value. Again, it's just a ratio of income over cost, but both components in the equation warrant some further explanation. In the real estate business, net operating income, also known as NOI, is the total annual income a property produces after vacancy and expenses. In other words, it's simply gross rent minus expenses. To determine the amount of gross rents, we start by considering what the subject property could generate in a perfect world if it was 100% occupied. Then we subtract the anticipated vacancy rate. So, for example, if a property could generate a maximum of $10,000 per year, but we expect it to have a vacancy rate of, say, 10%, then the most it can actually generate each year is $9,000. Our next step would be to subtract the annual expenses. This includes all of the anticipated items that will drain your bank account each year. This could include things like property taxes, insurance, utilities, maintenance and repairs, property management, HOA dues, and so on. One expense that's not included when calculating the cap rate is financing costs, such as a mortgage, principal, and interest payment. Cap rates do not include loans or leverage in any capacity. They analyze the raw income over the raw cost of a property because this number is not affected by the financing terms of the deal. Whether an investor buys a property for cash or they put 10% down or 25% down, the cap rate will always stay the same regardless of the financing situation. Now, when we say that the cap rate is NOI divided by market value or cost, let's explain this a little further. A property's cap rate can be calculated based on either the current market value of a property, the list price of a property, or the total cost you acquire it for. And these three things aren't always the same number. A property may be worth $700,000 in terms of market value, but if you know that you can acquire it while covering all closing costs and any immediate repairs for, say, $500,000, then that $500,000 becomes the more relevant number to use because that reflects the actual situation that you're in. Ultimately, the most useful way to calculate the cap rate is by starting with the price you expect to pay for the property, plus any additional costs required to close, plus any improvements needed to make the property functional. And yes, that means factoring the rehab into the total cost. Suppose you're able to buy a small apartment building all in for $500,000. After doing your research and crunching the numbers, you determine that the net operating income for 1 year will be as follows. $80,000 in annual gross potential rent minus 5% vacancy rate, or $4,000, equals $76,000 in annual gross rent. You also determine the annual expenses look like $5,000 in property costs, $3,000 in insurance, 8% or $6,400 in repairs, 5% or $4,000 in maintenance costs, 10% or $8,000 in property management costs, for a total annual expense amount of $26,400. After subtracting the $26,400 of annual expenses from the $76,000 annual gross rent, you'll have a net operating income of $49,600. If we take this $49,600 amount and then divide it by our total acquisition cost of $500,000, we now have a cap rate of 9.92%. Now that we understand the basics of how to calculate the cap rate and what this number actually tells us, let's talk about some of the pros and cons to using this formula as the basis for analyzing a real estate deal. A lot of people, especially in commercial real estate, treat this formula as the golden standard to analyzing deals. But now that you understand what this number is actually telling you, you might see value in weighing it against other methods of analysis. One of the major benefits to using cap rates is that they're a fast and simple way to estimate returns on any particular property. Cap rates are also a great tool to help you compare two different properties with one objective measurement. Imagine you have a choice between buying two identical properties across the street from each other. If one offers you a cap rate of 7% and the other offers 9% and everything else is equal, it would make much more sense to buy the property that's offering the higher cap rate. But the simplicity of a cap rate provides both advantages and some limitations. By removing interest and financing related costs from the equation, investors can use cap rates to compare the raw income returns between two properties. But financing is a huge component of making most deals work, so don't assume that cap rates tell the whole story. Another piece of the puzzle that cap rates ignore is the challenges that may arise in property management and rent collection. Two properties might have the exact same cap rate, yet one can be in an upscale neighborhood populated by reliable residents with great credit scores, and the other could be in a slum where late rents and defaults are the norm rather than the exception. In summary, cap rates are a useful shorthand calculation. You can do them on the back of a napkin in about 30 seconds, assuming you have accurate numbers available. The simplicity of a cap rate makes it an easy metric to use, especially when comparing returns between two properties. However, its simplicity also means its usefulness is limited and doesn't tell the full story about a property's returns. If you found this video helpful, you'll also like our videos that explain the cash on cash return and return on investment, which are two other formulas that can help you get a more holistic look at how good a deal might be. For more tips, tricks, and real world guidance on how to crush it as a real estate investor, be sure to check out REtipster.com to expand your real estate knowledge and build your financial future.